Hello, people. Variation. A circumstance which must contain endless change. There's only one thing that doesn't contain change of any sort, and that's the absolute of space. Clink there, clink. I click there for absolute, and a link there for space. Everything else has the inherent characteristic of change. We experience the changing nature of reality via these things, amongst others. It's not the only things, but time, love, shape, motion, it goes on and on. Up until that time when the one we refer to as the lover introduced or discovered a qualitative state, it was possible for him to experience an endless non-qualitative state. That wasn't something which any of us would find desirable, as indeed he didn't. And it came to be that a qualitative state did exist. It came to be understood that a qualitative state did exist, and that it increases in its qualitativeness, in the degree of its quality, the more it is enacted. It may be thought that surely somewhere along the line, somewhere in eternity, we do an exhausting of a variable might take place. Well, that's not the case. There's only the one absolute. There's only the one thing that cannot change and does not change. Within that reality of nothingness, everything, all things that can change, all things that can be, must keep on changing, otherwise we're into the outlook that we're approaching or trying to simulate or copy a a changelessness state. There's only one thing that can be changeless, and that is it. As a analogy, as an analogy, if we imagine the keyboard of a piano, we'll say it's got 5 octaves, which would be 12 notes per octave. So 5 times 12 is 50. Then what we have to do, so we've got 60. Now that's got to be multiplied by a time variation. We'll just say, for instance, that we've got 5 divisions between for each second, and that a typical the longest note lasts for 3 seconds. So that's 15. So what you have to do then is multiply 59 by 60, then multiply that by 58, then multiply that by 57, then multiply it by 56, then 55, then 54, then we just take it down to 50. And you get the idea. Within a couple more goes, we'll find that we'll start hitting the E numbers. Any second now. No, still not there. Right. So we know that we've got a number that big plus another 32 zeros after it. And you can keep on going on like that, and the computer will start grinding to a halt eventually, as it can't manage the size of the number being equated. And then to that, you have to have things like, so that's just with 60 notes with divisions of, how many would we say, 15. So when you've multiplied 60 all the way down to 2, then multiply that figure by 15, by 14, by 13, by 12, and you've got a bigger and bigger number. Then you introduce movement. Then you introduce dimensions, and so on and so forth. And then you introduce the notion of love, which is a self-reciprocating or a mutually reciprocating action, which has literally no end. The truly mind-boggling thing about the variables that love introduces is that it brings about an increasing qualitative state. So you're not just playing on a beach building sandcastles. You're playing on a beach building sandcastles that becomes more enjoyable the more you do it. I mean, anybody who doesn't want that future has got to be looked at by a doctor. But I know that doesn't apply to most of you listening or watching this. Most of you following these screencasts are in the happy state of knowing that that future is yours. See you later.